you are an Adobe Illustrator user that is transitioning to CorelDRAW, and or an Adobe Photoshop user that is transitioning to Corel PHOTO-PAINT, then this is the tutorial for you. Adobe Illustrator and CorelDRAW have many similarities, which makes it easy to move from one application to the other. Although they share some basic drawing and design capabilities, Illustrator and Draw are distinguished by some key terminology differences. Understanding these differences lets you make a quick transition to CorelDRAW. CorelDRAW includes a workspace that has the look and feel of Adobe Illustrator. This workspace can help you find menu commands and tools more easily. Let's now start working in the Adobe workspace and look at the terminology used in CorelDRAW. This document contains a list of the key terminology differences between Adobe Illustrator and CorelDRAW. For starters, artwork is often referred to as drawing. In CorelDRAW, there are pages instead of artboards. You can have multiple pages in a document, and you can easily switch between them. The collection of tools on the left is called the Toolbox. And just like the Tools panel in Illustrator, it is a toolbar with tools for creating, filling, and modifying objects in a drawing. The space above the document window is called the Property bar. Similar to the control panel in Illustrator, this toolbar contains commands that are related to the active tool or object. You can move a toolbar around by right-clicking on it and unchecking Lock Toolbars. The tabbed windows on the right are called dockers. Similar to the panels in Illustrator, these are windows containing commands and options that you can use while working on your document. For example, the Object Properties docker is like a combination of the Stroke, Character, Paragraph and Transparency panels in Illustrator. Right beside the dockers is the Color Palette, which is like the Swatches panel in Illustrator. At the bottom of the screen is the status bar, which is a bit different from the status bar in Illustrator. It contains information about object properties, such as type, size, color, fill, and resolution. Now that we have looked at the workspace, let's take a look at some of the tools that are available in CorelDRAW. The Shape tool is like the Direct Selection tool in Illustrator. With the Shape tool, you can edit the shape of objects like this one. These are referred to as curve objects in CorelDRAW. The anchor points you see here are called nodes, and the directional points are called control handles. Let's take a look at the object properties in the Object Properties docker. In CorelDRAW, the object stroke is called the outline. In the fill properties, you can apply various types of fill to the object. Gradient fill is referred to as fountain fill in CorelDRAW. There are also some commands in CorelDRAW that are equivalent to those in Adobe Illustrator, but have different names. Under the File menu, there is a command called Import. This is like the Place command in Illustrator, and lets you import a file and place it in the Active Application window as an object. You can rasterize an object by going to Bitmaps, Convert to Bitmap. This is the equivalent to the rasterize command in Illustrator. Guidelines are equivalent to guides in Illustrator. You can show or hide guidelines from the View menu. Here you can also enable alignment guides. And dynamic guides, which are similar to smart guides in Illustrator. Adobe Photoshop and Corel Photo Paint also have many similarities, which makes it easier to transition from one application to the other. But again, there are some key differences in terminology. Corel Photo Paint includes a workspace that has the look and feel of Adobe Photoshop, helping Photoshop users to get started quickly. Let's click on the Adobe Photoshop workspace and take a quick look at some of the terminology used in Corel Photo Paint. The workspace terminology used in Photo Paint is identical to that of CorelDRAW. For example, the tabbed windows on the right are called dockers. Let's take a look at the Object Manager docker. This is similar to the Layers panel in Photoshop, but there are some key differences in terminology. In PhotoPaint, layers are referred to as objects. Object properties are like layer options. You can access this by double-clicking on an object. Photoshop adjustment layers are called lenses in Corel PhotoPaint. With lenses, you can view the effect of a correction through a lens without permanently changing the underlying pixels. Blend modes in Photoshop are known as merge modes in PhotoPaint. Merge modes determine how the selected paint object or fill color will combine with the other colors in the image. The Rectangle Mask tool is similar to the Rectangular Marquee tool in Photoshop. It lets you define rectangular editable areas or selections in your document. These editable areas are called masks in PhotoPaint. Clip masks are the equivalent to layer masks in Photoshop. Clip masks let you edit an object's transparency levels without affecting the pixels in the object. Under the Image menu, there are a couple of commands that are the same as those in Adobe Photoshop, but have different names. The Resample command is the same as the Image Size command in Photoshop, which lets you change the resolution and dimensions of an image. The Paper Size command is like the Canvas Size command in Photoshop. Changing the paper size lets you change the dimensions of the printable area, which contains both the image and the paper. This concludes the tutorial on the key terminology differences between Adobe Illustrator and CorelDRAW, as well as Adobe Photoshop and Corel Photo Paint. Visit the Help chapter to learn more about comparing terminology and tools. And be sure to visit CorelDRAW.com and become part of an inspiring community where users of all backgrounds can connect, learn, and share.